Don't be a boob. For more videos like this one, please subscribe to this channel.
Sun look too. That was the case over so much of the West Coast, really up and down the entire seaboard. Now, the El Dorado fire in San Bernardino County is quickly approaching 10,000 acres, containment only 7%. And because of gusty winds today, PG&E is cutting electricity to parts of 22 Northern California counties to prevent downed power lines from igniting fires. The utility says 172,000 customers will be impacted. Steph, the winds are going to be very extreme. Temperatures, we get some help. But the wind is going to be the big factor.
It is a huge factor. And everywhere you see these white lines, these are isobars. So there's the same pressure all along this line, then the same pressure all along this line. And the closer they are together, the stronger the winds are. Okay, and so we have our big high pressure to the north, our front to the south, and they're getting squeezed in between. Now, we actually could have, or we're getting close to, a September record high pressure in Montana. Right now, the high pressure is 1,038 millibars. But the record pressure is 1,042 millibars. And so we're really close to a September record high pressure there into Montana. That's just a meteorological fact. High pressure means that you're gonna have that, you know, cold, dry air coming on down. So here's a look at all the fires if we look yesterday, but we want you to focus in on what's happening here in the eastern Washington. These fires just sparked yesterday. They weren't there in the morning. They're not there, but you'll notice they pop into the scene here as we head into the afternoon hours. And of course, the winds played a role in that. You see how breezy it was yesterday, up to 70 mile an hour winds. That, along with the fires, taking out some power here, and the alerts continue all along the All right, well, we want to take you into San Antonio. And listen, it is cloudy in San Antonio this morning. Rainy day ahead for us here along that I-35 stretch, major thoroughfare. Of course, I-35 goes from Laredo, Texas at the Mexico border all the way north into Duluth, Minnesota. 1,568.38 miles. I want to know who measured that exactly. How did that exactly all work out? All right, let's take you traveling here. If you're doing any traveling on the highways, whether it's I-35 up towards Oklahoma, or if you're taking that I-10 corridor, you could run into some of those showers and thunderstorms. This isn't the stuff that's going to necessarily knock your socks off unless you're stuck under one of these thunderstorms, you know, around the Houston-Galveston area. Those could definitely be on the more powerful side here. But as we go through the day today, you know, we will see that rain. We will see the showers. It will be on and off, heavier for some of you. And then it will kind of lighten up into places like San Antonio. But it goes through Houston. By the way, Amarillo, Lubbock, enjoy the warm temperatures and that rain, because look at that system dropping down. Our temperatures are going to drop significantly into the panhandle of Texas. We'll show you that. It doesn't look like any snow is going to make it in, but it's certainly going to feel cold enough for snow, Jim, because it's been so warm as of late.
What is it, like 71 right now in Amarillo? But it's going to be dropping
by this afternoon.
Rock.
Yeah.
That's a big on the ground in Denver, because you're not getting that sun.
Right.
Yeah,
exactly. The sun angle is changing a little bit.
They're starting with a warm surface temperature.
Jim, how about this? 49 degree drop at the Air Force Academy. North of Colorado Springs, 49 degree drop in 12 hours.
That's going to hurt.
49 degree drop. I'm waiting for this guy to hit me back on Twitter.
Where was the 61?
He didn't respond yet. I just looked. It was 61 degree drop in 15 and a half hours. And so I'm waiting to get the response of where exactly he was located. Oof. That is just cool, right? It's just impressive. Oof. Even if you're not affected by this, how interesting is that, right? And, you know, even if you just look over, I was trying to look up some miles, like, okay, from, you know, Denver to Amarillo, how many miles it is right over the front. It's not a huge distance. I was looking in Kansas. I mean, it's something like around 100 miles that separates, you know, the 70s from the 50s. We do have advisories here, hard freeze warnings posted for us here, and a freeze warning is when our temperatures are at or below 32 for at least 2 hours. Hard freeze is 28, and that really makes a difference with your plants, the 32 versus the 28. So the 30s here throughout the northern tier, though, in this area, and I've been to International Falls, 36, they're probably just still wearing like a long sleeve shirt, maybe jeans. I mean, they are hardy people up here, but there is still a freeze warning and freeze watch, and there's that cold air. Focus on Amarillo. You're the next city to really see that significant drop. So your temperature is going to be dropping through the day. In Amarillo, you have to make sure you bring that jacket, Jen, because on the way home, it's going to be 20 degrees colder.
That's the thing. I mean, you need to know what to wear. I mean, it's not over the course of a couple of days. It's within hours you'll see these changes. Hey, Phoenix, we've got a good change for the better. Now, you are our hottest spot on the map board today. We got 101 degrees for you, but you're going to have your coolest day in months as we see temperatures drop into the 90s. That's going to happen. Now, check this out. It's a smoke NATO. Look at this thing here, swirling over the road full of dirt and ash. This is in the El Dorado fire in Southern California. And I mean, look, you can see the flames, obviously, but look at the smoke billowing up and spinning here. Very volatile situation. The fires have just been explosive in their growth. There have been a lot of plume structure with them as well. And unfortunately, they have been growing very aggressively in size. So I want to run through some of the stats and where we are right now with the fire danger today and where we are in the season. We have 77 active fires that are the big ones, 100 acres or larger in size. There are more, though, smaller ones in place as well. But these are the big ones getting tracked right here. So we do have the red flag warnings up today, up and down the west. Look, all the way from Southern California right up into the northwest. So we've got a couple of different areas of focused winds. One is going to be in Southern California where the Santa Ana winds start to pick up. We will see that as we get into the later hours today, then into tomorrow. And then we also have two other areas of really strong winds. It happens to be another offshore wind. The Santa Ana is an offshore wind. But up here into the northwest where around the Portland area all night long, we were gusting to close to 50 miles per hour. Close to 40, close to 50 all night long. Started to calm down a little bit, coming down into the 30s, but a lot of smoke getting blown into the area as well. We do have that fire risk. Now, look at California and all of the fires that we have, and most importantly, how big they are. I'm going to put up some perspective for you right here. We've got the SCU, the LNU, and the August Complex fires. This is the second, third, and fourth largest fires in California history, and they are happening right now. Now, acreage burned in California tops the list here in the most here on record. And unfortunately, even if you haven't been affected directly by a fire, chances are you may have been affected by smoke. That has been pretty widespread. September 2nd to September 7th, look at the difference in just how widespread the smoke is, and it's especially stuck in some areas, like in the Central and Southern Valley here. This is where air quality alerts are up again today. And also still in parts of Colorado, we still have air quality alerts despite all the other changes happening there in the weather.
Oh, we've got to show you Colorado. Yeah.